If you're creating the same type of Basecamp projects over and over again, you need to simplify your life and create a Basecamp template. I'm Kimberly from Basecamp's Customer Success team, and in this video, I'm going to show you how to do it. To make the template, you'll click Make a New Project from your home screen, and then Create a Project Template near the bottom. Now, if there are already templates on your account, this screen will look a little different, and you'll select Use a Template, and then Edit Templates. Either way, you'll end up on the Project Templates page where you'll select the new template card with the green plus button. You'll name your project template and give it a description if you want to. Then hit Next. From here, you can set up your template just like you would any Basecamp project. You can change or rename the project tools with the three-dot menu at the top right. Think about this template as the basis for all the projects of this type. If you want those projects to start with a specific message on the message board, go ahead and post it. If you want your project to have a few files already preloaded, go ahead and add them in. You can even create to-do lists and assign tasks to people on your team from within the template. But don't worry, they won't be alerted about these assignments until you actually create the project from the template. But if you want to wait to assign those tasks until after the project has been created, that's fine too. When you have your template set up the way you want it, and you're ready to create a new project from that template, you'll go to Make a New Project from your home screen, Use a Template, and from the dropdown, select the template you want to use. You'll give your project a name, and you can add a description here as well. Click Create This Project and Basecamp will spin up a new project based on the template. Anyone assigned to do's or added to an event on the schedule in the template will automatically be invited to the project when it's created. They'll also be notified of any assignments in their Hey menu. Easy, right? Now, there is one thing to know when it comes to templates, and that's around dates. Because you can start a project from a template at any time, you can't assign specific due dates to tasks or put specific event dates on the calendar when you're creating your template. If you use that template a year from now or 6 months from now, those dates might not make sense or they might be in the past. So instead, Basecamp uses relative dates inside the template and then pre-populates those dates based on when you start the project. It's actually easier than it sounds. Let me show you. Let's edit the template by going to Make a New Project, Use a Template, Edit Templates. When I add a due date to a task, instead of the calendar pop-up you'd see when you're inside a project, you'll see a listing of days of the week along with a week number. You can choose the due date relative to when the project starts. So if I have a task that's always due the first week of a project on Friday or the second week of a project on Wednesday, you can set that here. Now, keep in mind that week one of your project always begins on the Sunday, the week you create the project. So just know if you have a relative due date of Monday, week one, and you start that project on a Thursday, that task is gonna already seem overdue. When you start a new project from the template, you can indicate a specific start date in this area. If you leave it blank, your start date will default to the day you created the Basecamp project. When Basecamp creates your project from the template, any relative dates on to-dos or on the schedule will become actual dates based on the project start date. It's like magic. One tip before we wrap up. If you have to-do lists that you find yourself doing over and over again that you don't necessarily need a new project for, you can create a to-do list template. The steps are similar to creating a project template that we just went over, but you can find the step-by-step detailed instructions in a video all about to-dos. I'll link to it in the YouTube description for this video.